Welcome back to Fire Emblem Blazing Sword. I'm halfway through this chapter. Let's do it, try and finish this up. Shine broke. Level up. Level 17. Level up. Level up. 13. Hold on, what's this? Set. Looks like another ring for Niels. Level up. Level 13. Weapon level increased. Nice job. Level up. Level up. Right. The steel axe broke. Level up. Dun 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 dun. I will take your life and your essence, all for the sake of my master. Level up. All right. Nice job, Jafar. Nice try. Nice try. Thank you. Weapon level increase. There we go. Fire broke. I am not human. This body and this heart are constructs. Yes, as is this heart. Man. It got dark there. Got a Fiendbolt Venter. Thank you.
That was a heated battle.
I thought it was going to go on forever.
It's not finished yet. Nurgle is waiting at the dragon's gate.
Nurgle.
He must pay.
Before we go to the dragon's gate, Niels, if you don't mind, would you share your story with us? Huh? I won't force you if you don't want to.
Okay, I'll tell you. I want you all to know about me and Nelian.
A millennium ago, many chased dragonkind from the land, exiled us. We had no place to go, not in this world, so we used the dragon's gate to flee into another. When we passed through this chasm in space and time, many of us were lost. Still, we endured the journey. We found humans there too, but they were few in number. We had a few skirmishes, but at last we found a home. We were stable there, happy even. But some thought back on our former home, and when we did, his voice reached out to us. Nelian was a medium to the other world, an oracle of sorts. She sat at the dragon's shrine. She held much power. We were in prayers at the shrine when it happened. We heard a voice calling to us from the dragon's gate. It was the voice of an old friend. We knew we weren't supposed to open the gate and return to this world. We had no idea that the owner of the voice was Nurgle.
Nurgle?
But something unexpected happened. When we opened the dragon's gate and traveled here again, we had lost almost all of our strength. The quintessence left within us was less than that, that of an average human. In order to sustain ourselves, in order to breathe the air of this world, we took human form. We placed our energies within a dragon stone. But our dragon stone was taken, stolen. Nurgle hoped to use it as a tool to summon the other dragons. Until we escaped, we couldn't let our foolishness condemn our friends.
Disguised as a dancer and a bard, we fled and wandered from country to country. That's when we first met Lady Lindis 1 year ago.
That whole time Nurgle was after you. Why didn't you tell me?
You were so good to us. We didn't want you to cause you any trouble. After we left Lynn at Kaelin, we were captured again. We decided that the only way to escape was to cut short our own lives. That was when we met Lord Elbert. He was so strong, so kind. He knew what we were and what we had done, and he never once condemned us. On the contrary, he tried to set us at ease with stories, stories of his family, of his homeland. Nelian and I, we listened to his stories, we grew to love his gentle wife and his son. Premotion, no, that's too strong a word, but he felt his son would be the one to save us. That's what he felt.
That's why, Lord Eliwood.
I believe you, even though Nelian's gone, I will continue to protect you. I have to.
That's Nelian's wish. That's our wish. Let's stop Nurgle. You're the only one who can do it. Niels. Let's do it, Eliwood. He's right. It's too early to give up. I mean, you're still here. You're still alive. Everyone. You're right, my friends. My friends are here with me. There's no power on this earth stronger than that. Let's go. The Dragon's Gate awaits.
That's where we'll shatter Nurgle's ambition. Well, hope you liked this video, and stay tuned.